my name is Luke Rappers, and I'm the executive director of Abundant Silence. And basically what I do is help support the work of living composers. So I do things like host composition contests, and I have of which Isaac is one of the winners. And I do a student event in Colorado every year called the Festival for Creative Pianists. We also publish the works by the composers who are on our roster. And what else do we do? A few things. Help support new music in any way we can and to celebrate new music. So we do that both here in Vermont and Colorado and anywhere we can to spread the word about the amazing work that living composers are doing and the art they're creating. So the other thing I'll say is this is an informal event. It's called New Music Uncaged because my intention is to get this music out of the concert hall and into the communities, sometimes outdoors when we can. So it's an informal thing. Feel free to go grab treats. People have already got some treats. Go grab some more. And if there might be some left after the concert, so we'll hang around and chat after the concert. I'd love to talk about new music. So without further ado, I'm going to welcome up our dancers to the stage and stage area. The first piece today is a series of 24 preludes by interdisciplinary artist Nathan Hall. Nathan Hall lives in Denver, Colorado, and is an amazing artist who does cool things like car key orchestras at the Denver Art Museum, has done some installations in Iceland. And for this piece, Nathan collaborated with a pianist and worked together to write these 24 preludes. So there's one for each month of the year and for each corresponding zodiac sign. So a good place to clap, if you're inclined to do so, would be following the month in the zodiac.
Thank you. Thank you.
I love it when visual artists write music because you get commands like dusty counterpoint and stoic is one of my feelings. Anyway. Some terms that I'm not used to. Okay, I'm going to welcome to the stage Mary Rowell for our next piece. The next piece, Isaac, did you want to say anything about the music?
Okay.
Yes, he does.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. So my piece is called Forces of Flight, and it's largely in the 4-4 previous students. So in physics, I took the four forces that act on a body in flight, and I sort of made a musical comparison to certain events that happen in one's life. For example, force movement, drag, kind of represents the equivalent, which is when things start to slow down, settle in place.
Those are five very short movements.
Thank you. Michael Gloss.
Performing a piece by Ayumi Okada, a four-movement piece, right? Four movements, called In the Ancient Forest. Ayumi Okada was one of the first composers, a roster of composers for my nonprofit organization, of which there are about 35 now. But Ayumi was one of the first, and this is partly one of the reasons why I love new music, is getting to meet the composer. Anytime I'm in New York, I have lunch with Ayumi, and we talk about music and talk about what she's writing, and it's really awesome to be able to do that and to hear what the composer's trying to communicate and how they're trying to express themselves in the world.
One of the great things about playing the music with living composers is I came to a part that I wasn't quite sure of the interpretation. I was able to just pick up the phone and ask a question. So it's a real treat to be here playing with Luke and Mary. And I'm also a composer on the roster of Abundant Silence, so it's a treat to be playing this wonderful new music. In this piece, Ayumi evokes the sounds of an ancient forest, where it evokes the feeling of an ancient forest using the cello. You'll hear misty forest after a heavy rain in the calm, a sound of a hurried woodpecker pecking. You'll hear forest nymphs playfully talking with one another, and a seabird circling over the forest. Right? In the ancient forest.
Thank you.
Virginia called The Poison Arrow. I'm just going to read Grisha's performance notes for you. The title of The Poison Arrow refers to one of the Buddha's sermons. A young man comes to Siddhartha Gautama with a barrage of ontological questions. How long has the universe been in existence? Who created it, etc.? Gautama replies with an analogy. It's just as if a man were wounded with an arrow thickly smeared with poison. His friends and companions, kinsmen and relatives, would provide him with a surgeon, and the man would say, I won't have this arrow removed until I know whether the man who wounded me was a noble warrior, a priest, a merchant, or a worker. He would say, I won't have this arrow removed until I know the given name and clan of the man who wounded me. The man would die, and those things would still remain unknown to him. In the Buddhist teaching, speculative philosophies are not important. What matters is figuring out how to overcome suffering in everyday life. We will all die without answering the mysteries of physics and metaphysics, so the appropriate thing to do is to focus significant attention on living a better life here and now. The first movement of The Poison Arrow depicts suffering and a frantic, often fruitless attempt to find a way out. The second movement is a depiction of life without suffering, completely placid and free.
Thank you.
composer from Croatia, Ivan Bozikovic. And this piece is called Canto della Ava Rapiega, or Song of the Bird of Prey. This is a two-movement work, and we're going to bring Annalisa back up for this last piece. And thank you all so much for coming out. It's great to see so many people out enjoying art here in Montpelier. Feel free to grab more treats on the way out. I have a donation box there. Give what you can. All the money goes to support these amazing performers and composers that keeps this music flowing. So anything you can do to help with that would be very much appreciative. And I don't have programs for you, but if you want a sheet that lists all of the composers' names and pieces and also has our website on it, those are back by the reception area. So you can take that home with you. Look up a composer. So this is Canto della Ava Rapiega.
To Mary Rowell for joining us on violin, to Turner Music, to our partners Turn Music, The Garage, and Current Harbor Dance, and our dancers today, Annalisa Ledson and Charlotte
Feinberg.
Feinberg. thank you all for coming. Hope to see you again soon.